It's Yom Kippur and I need much more atonement than I could ever ask for. This song I send to you, my friend, in case I offended, let's make amends. Please forgive me if I wronged you, and if you wronged me, I forgive you too. And may God forgive all of Israel like he forgave Yonah in the way. The word of Hashem came one day to Yonah ben Amittai to say, go to the great city of Nineveh and call them out for their wicked ways. But Yonah did not want to go, so he ignored the Lord and just tried to flee. He found some sailors, paid them a fee, and journeyed with them out into the sea. So God sent a mighty wind, it blew, threatened to break the ship in two. The crew was afraid, what should they do? Yonah was the only one who knew. He said, this storm is because of me. Far away from God, I tried to flee. So pick me up, throw me in the sea, and then Hashem will let you be. The sailors thought that was too hardcore. Instead, they tried to row back to shore. But when the storm increased even more, they listened and threw Yonah overboard. And from the moment he was released, the waters were calm, the wind just ceased. Hashem let the sailors go in peace, while Yonah sunk to the deepest deeps. God sent a great big whale his way and swallowed Yonah. And so he stayed inside of a whale for 3-4 days. He turned his heart to Hashem and prayed. And since God hears the voice of man, he forgave Yonah and gave the command for the whale to spit him out on dry land. And Yonah was back right where he began. It's Yom Kippur and I need much more atonement than I could ever ask for. To you I send this song, my friend, in case I offended, let's make amends. Please forgive me if I wronged you, and if you wronged me, I forgive you too. And may God forgive all of Israel like he forgave Yonah in the whale. The word of Hashem came back that day to Yonah again, saying, don't delay, go to the great city of Nineveh and say to them what I tell you to say. So Yonah complied, he went for a ride to the great city that was so wide, was a 3-day journey from side to side. He went to the center of town and cried, saying, pay attention, for Nineveh will be wiped away in 40 days. But the people, they heard what he had to say. They believed in God and they changed their ways. All over the city it became known. His word even reached the king on his throne, who commanded that all of his people atone. The transformation, it was full blown. They fasted, sat in ashes, lamented. From their deeds God saw they'd repented. They stopped doing evil, so he relented. But Yonah was angry at God, he vented, I'm fed up, is this not why I fled? When you should do harm to the wicked instead, you showed them mercy, so now go ahead, just take my life, for I'd rather be dead. Now God decided he had to show Yonah a lesson that he didn't know. So he commanded a plant to grow. It rose up above Yonah's head below. He felt relieved as he sat in his shade and greatly rejoiced in the plant God made. But God sent a worm the very next day to attack the plant, and the plant decayed. Now the sun beat down on Yonah's head until his skin was burnt and red. Feeling faint, he asked for death, he said, with this kind of life, I'd rather be dead. God said to Yonah, I really can't believe that you're grieving about this plant, which you did not work for in any way, and which lived and died in a single day. And as for me, should I not have pity upon Nineveh, this enormous city with thousands of human beings who might not know their left hand from their right? It's Yom Kippur and I need much more atonement than I could ever ask for. This song I send to you, my friend, in case I offended, let's make amends. Please forgive me if I wronged you, and if you wronged me, I forgive you too. And may God forgive all of Israel like he forgave Yonah in the whale.